Welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today, we're diving into another Pipedrive integration. We're going to be talking about how to connect Asana to Pipedrive. This video is sponsored by Pipedrive. It's great to have them as a sponsor. They are doing a monthly feature with us, so you can check out Pipedrive in the link in the description. Now, many people want to be able to connect their project manager with something like a sales CRM to be able to manage the process, especially have that differentiation between two applications. And obviously we've talked about how you can manage deals inside of Pipedrive with some of the more beneficial integrations like scheduling meetings, organizing and documenting information that comes into the system. But we haven't really talked about some of the integrations that you can connect with. So if I go back to deals here, you can see that as somebody that might be managing a pipeline as part of your sales team, it can be quite difficult sometimes to keep on track of some of the tasks. There's some built-in features in Pipedrive, but a lot of people already have a project management application. And in this case, you may even be watching this video with Asana as your project manager. Now, Asana is a really powerful tool for being able to manage tasks and projects in one, and it's been on the market for a while now. And as you can see, I've got a post-sales handoff project created here to really manage the process of new, well, maybe potentially new customers, but you can have it set up to however you like. In this example, any sale that goes past the negotiation phase, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up the integration to be able to populate it in Asana so that I can keep track of it. Because obviously, that's really the place where you're going to be keeping track of potentially any tasks or other relationship elements, as well as Pipedrive if you did want to. But let's show you how you can do that. Now, all you have to do is go up to the top right-hand corner, press company settings, and you'll find the company settings area. On the left-hand side, you'll find tools and apps. Now, obviously, we've talked about this before. You can connect up a wide range of applications, and there is an integration here for Asana. And there are actually two here. There's Asana and then Asana New. Now, Asana New has more of the workflow automation, which we'll cover in another feature. However, in terms of just the basics we're going to cover today is the Asana integration. Now, what this basically does is anytime you create, like, a Pipedrive event changes that you want to move between a specific stage on the pipeline, then what it will do is it will create a task in Asana. That can be really helpful from a variety of reasons, just keeping track and making sure you're building and maintaining relationships. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and authorize the Asana account. Now, authorization doesn't take long and it helps you connect to your Asana account. And as you can see, this is what comes up on the screen next. You can see that you can start connecting the two up. Now, this part of the process is actually where you trigger the event. What event is going to be the thing that nudges it to create a task in Asana? Now, for example, you can set this up as if a deal is won or lost, but in this case, I'm actually going to say if a deal is moved into a new area. For example, I'm going to connect the pipeline because that's the one I've connected, but you can choose a pipeline that you've created alternately. But I'm also going to set, as I said, put it in the negotiation started. So if anything is moved into this stage of the pipeline, now what will happen is it will create a task in Asana. But I'm going to add a bit more detail so it knows information that I might be able to see at a glance without having to necessarily come back to Pipedrive as well. So you can transfer some details. For example, default, it will bring in the deal title, but you can bring in the deal value, pin notes and attachments, contact details and organization. In some cases, you might want to remove these if it's something that you don't want to bring over, but it might be helpful. For example, just have the contact details for the person you've been interacting with. Now, negotiation started, I want to put here because this might be a prompt, for example, to say, you know, I need to build a stronger rapport with this person during this process and maybe take them out for a meal or something like that. But it just prompts it in Asana if you hit that certain stage of the process. Same again with any of the other elements as well. For example, if you went sort of backwards to say you had a demo scheduled, but then you made that contact and it sort of went backwards in the process, how you set it up, and naturally that it still sort of operates like that. And you can choose what type of item you create, a task or a project. In this case, I'm just going to create a task and connect it to that post-sales handoff that I created earlier. Now, as your team, it pulls in whoever you're working with in the Asana workspace that you have. So for example, it's just myself. I'm going to press save changes and we're going to move a certain stage and we'll show you what happens when it's all connected. Okay, so I have this already. And let's just say, for example, this Bookshop Inc. deal moved over to the negotiation started. As you can see, it's now moved to this key element. And let's go over to Asana to see what's changed. Now, as you can see there, the Bookshop deal Inc. is populated. And if I go into details, I can see a little bit more about each of the deals that I have. For example, it's John Appleseed with this number and this deal value as well, which is perfect for being able to keep track of stuff. And I can go ahead and do all the regular stuff I would in Asana, like for example, add a due date, assign it to other people, make subtasks, and many more elements of this too. I can even start interacting in comments as well. And the great thing is I can actually move it to a certain stage as well. For example, it could be onboarding, ongoing support, because that might be more relevant. And that's a great way to keep track of, for example, tasks that you need to do, and make sure you're managing the process in Pipedrive as well as Asana. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Please do let us know if you have any questions in the comments below, and stay tuned next month for our Pipedrive feature. And a big thank you to Pipedrive for sponsoring today's feature. See you guys very soon. Thank you very much, and I'll talk later.